Hello everyone. So dear students, we are continuing the problems with principles of mathematical induction. In our previous sessions, we have studied few of the exercise problems related to this principle of mathematical induction. Today we shall continue the same part. Let us look over the first problem of today's session. What is the first problem given here? It is given that prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. Prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. Mathematical induction. For all n belongs to n, for all n belongs to n, what is the, it is given that a plus ar plus ar square plus so on up to ar raised to n minus 1 is equals to a into r raised to n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. This is our given problem. Now let us solve one by one. Again the same things we need to recall. Let the given statement be P of n. We'll write it in the same way. That is, let the given statement be P of n. Then if it is P of n, how we are going to write it? P of n such that a plus ar plus ar square so on up to ar raised to n minus 1 is equals to a into r raised to n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. So what is our next step? Our next step is that for n is equals to 1, what we will be having? For n is equals to 1, p of 1 such that it is a. This will be equal to a into r raised to 1 minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Nothing but a into r minus 1 divided by r minus 1. R minus 1 and r minus 1 is going to get cancelled, which is equals to a. We got a is equals to a, which is true. Which is true. Next. Consider P of k is true for some positive integer 2. For some positive integer k. That is, let P of k be true. Let P of k be true for some positive integer. Positive integer. What is that positive integer? That positive integer is k. That is how we can write. We can write P of k such that a plus ar plus ar square so on up to ar raised to k minus 1 is equals to a into r raised to k minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Consider this as equation 1. Now what will be our next step? Our next step is that we shall now prove that P of k plus 1 is true. How we are going to write? We shall now prove that P of k plus 1 is true. How we are going to write if it is true? That is, a plus ar plus ar square so on up to ar. In place of r, we are going to write, we here have k, right? In place of k, we are supposed to write k plus 1. Ar raised to k plus 1. Sorry, first ar raised to k. Ar raised to k minus 1 plus ar raised to k plus 1 minus 1. So this is our given problem. A r raised to k minus 1 plus a r raised to k plus 1 minus 1. This we shall group it. That is a r plus a r square, so on up to a r raised to k minus 1 plus a r raised to k plus 1 minus 1. See, a r plus a r square, so on, can this can be replaced by a into r raised to k, a into r raised to k minus 1 divided by r minus 1 plus a r raised to k. We got here as a r raised to k. If it is a r raised to k, take the LCM. We have, what we have done here? Using equation 1. If so, take the LCM. A into r raised to k minus 1 plus a into r raised to k r minus 1 whole divided by r minus 1. Now, a r raised to k minus 1 plus a r raised to k into r minus 1 divided by r minus 1. What we have done? We have just taken the LCM. How we can write it? Just split the brackets. That is a into r raised to k minus 1 plus a into r raised to k plus 1 minus a into r raised to k divided by r minus 1. Just simplify this side also. That is a into r raised to k minus a plus a into r raised to k plus 1 minus a r raised to k divided by r minus 1. Now what is going to happen? A r raised to k got cancelled. We are left with a r raised to k plus 1 minus a divided by r minus 1. This can be written as a into r raised to k plus 1 minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Hence, we showed that P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Thus, what we will write? Thus, P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Whenever P of k is true. Again, therefore, by the principle of mathematical induction, what we have the principle of mathematical induction? We know that it is going to be true for all natural numbers, that is n. Now, let us move to the next problem. We are just using the same principle of mathematical induction, that is first considering it true for n is equals to 1, then assuming that the given problem is true for k, and then if it is true for k, then we will prove that it is true for p of k plus 1. Now let us focus on the next problem. What is the next problem given? It is given that prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. Let's look over the second problem. What is given? It is given that prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. Prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. What is the problem given? It is given that for all n belongs to n, one plus 3 by 1 1 plus 5 by 4, 1 plus 7 by 9, so on, 1 plus 2n plus 1 divided by 2. This is equals to n plus 1 whole square. Now we shall prove this using mathematical induction. Again, let the given statement be P of n. Let the given statement be P of n. How we are going to write it? We are going to write it as P of n such that 1 plus 3 by 1 into 1 plus 5 by 4 into 1 plus 7 by 9, so on up to 1 plus 2n plus 1 divided by 2. This is equals to n plus 1 square. Now for n is equals to 1, we are going to prove that we have, that is, for n is equals to 1, we have P of 1 such that it is 1 plus 3, which is equals to 4. This should be equals to 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 1 divided by 2. This we are going to write as 1 plus 3 by 2. It is it is n square divided by n square. If it is n square, then it's going to be here 1 square, nothing but 1, which is equals to 4. 4 is equals to 4, which is true. Next, what we are going to do, for let P of k be true for some positive integer k. That is, let P of k, this be true. Let P of k be true for some positive integer k. Then how we are going to write it? We are going to write it as P of k such that 1 plus 3 by 1 into 1 plus 5 by 4 into 1 plus 7 by 9, so on, it is, I guess, into 1 plus 2k plus 1 divided by k square. Let us group this as one term. This is equals to what? This will be equal to k plus 1 whole square. Let us consider this as equation 1. Now we shall prove that P of k plus 1 is true. What we shall prove? We shall prove that P of k plus 1 is true. If so, how we are going to get it? 1 plus 3 by 1, just group of, into 1 plus 5 by 4 into 1 plus 7 by 9, so on up to 1 plus 2k plus 1 divided by k square, plus we are doing it for k plus 1th term, which will be equal to 1 plus 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 divided by k square. So this entire term can be replaced by equation 1, which is k plus 1 whole square into, we are left with 1 plus 2k + 2 + 1 divided by k square. We have this term. Now how we are going to simplify it? Just go on taking LCM. We will write it as k plus 1 whole square into k square plus 2k plus 3 divided by k square. We have k square plus 2k. This can be written as, or keeping it as it is, we get it as 2k, 2 times of k plus 1. Keep it as it is. Here also keep it as it is. That is k plus 1 whole square into k square plus 2 times of k plus 1 plus 1 whole divided by k square. We have this. So how we are going to write this? K plus 1 whole square into 2k plus 2 into, taking out just k plus 1 whole square. That is, we have outside here k plus 1 whole square. Take it outside. Just a minute. K plus 1 whole square. It is for k plus 1 whole square. Here you are going to get it as k plus 1 whole square. Then on taking LCM, what you are going to get? K plus 1 whole square. Again, k plus 1 whole square plus 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 divided by k plus 1 whole square. Now, taking out k plus 1 whole square as common, then you are going to get here as k plus 1 whole square. We are left out with what? We are left out with k plus 1 whole square plus 2 times of k plus 1 plus 1, nothing but k plus 1 whole square into, this can be written as plus k plus 1 whole square plus 2 times of k plus 1 plus 1 divided by k plus 1. Just cancelling of these two terms. On cancelling, just directly we are going to get this as k plus 1 whole square plus 2 times of k plus 1 plus 1. We had k plus 1 whole square. We got it as k plus 1 whole square plus 2k plus 1 plus 1. This can be written as k plus 1 plus 1 whole square. This we can write it as k plus 1 plus 1 whole square. Thus what we proved? We proved that P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Thus what we are going to write? Thus P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Hence, again by the principle of mathematical induction, the statement P of n is true for all natural numbers, that is n. Very simple thing. What we have considered? We have considered the given statement as P of n. We proved it is true when n is equals to 1. Then we considered that it is true for some positive integer k. Nothing but in place of n, we have substituted k plus 1 whole square. Now we are going to prove that it is true for k plus 1 also. Then what we did, we added one extra term, that is 1 plus 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 divided by k plus 1 whole square. We substituted this entire part by using equation 1, which is equals to k plus 1 whole square. K plus 1 whole square into 1 plus 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 divided by k plus 1 whole square. Next, on taking LCM, we got k plus 1 whole square plus 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 divided by k plus 1 whole square. K plus 1 whole square and k plus 1 whole square got cancelled. Then we got k plus 1 whole square plus 2 into k plus 1 plus 1. This is of the form k plus 1 into k plus 1 plus 1 whole square. Hence, we proved that P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Therefore, by principle of mathematical induction, it is true for all natural numbers. Now, let us again move on with the next problem. Here, all the problems are similar. We just need to be careful while we are simplifying. What is the next problem given? Prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction for all n belongs to n. Same again. Prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction for all n belongs to n, we have 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on up to n. This is less than 1/8, 2n plus 1 whole square. Again, the same thing, let the statement be P of n, then P of n, how we are going to write? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on up to n less than 1/8 into 2n plus 1 whole square. Let us see that it is true for n plus 1. It can be noted that P of n is true. How we can write? P of n is true. It can be noted that P of n is true for n is equals to 1. How we are going to write it? P of 1 such that 1, it is less than 1/8 into 2 into 1 plus 1 square. Then what it is? It is less than 3 square by 8, nothing but it is less than 9/8. Obviously, 1 is going to be less than 9 divided by 8. Now, what we are going to prove the next step? We'll assume that it can, then let P of K be true. Let P of K be true where K is some positive integer. That is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on up to k. This is less than 1 divided by 8 into 2k plus 1 square. Consider this as equation 1. Now what we are going to do? Now we shall prove that it is true for P of k plus 1. We shall prove that P of K plus 1 is true. We are going to write it as 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on up to K plus 1. This can be written as, this is less than, just how we can write this? This can be written as less than 1/8 into 2k plus 1 whole square plus k plus 1. What we have done here? By using equation 1, we wrote that it is less than 1/8 into 2k plus 1 square plus k plus 1. this can be further simplified as this is less than 1 by 8 2k plus 1 whole square as that is 1 by 8 2k plus 1 whole square plus 2k plus 1 whole square plus 8 times of k plus 1. That is, on opening the bracket, we are again going to get the same terms back. That is 2k plus 1 whole square plus 8. Just open the bracket, you are going to again get it as k plus 1. If it is so, we are going to get it as 1 by 8 into, just simplify the terms in the given bracket, that is 4 k square plus 2k plus 1 plus 8k plus 8. This can be written as less than 1 by 8 into 4k square plus 10k plus 9. This can be written as, that is, less than 1 by 8 into 1 by 8 into 2k plus 3 whole square. If so it is like this, how we can write this further? We'll say that it is less than 1 by 8 into 2k plus 1 plus 1 whole square. We wrote it as 2k plus 3 is written as 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 whole square. That is, we proved that it is true for P of k plus 1. How you are going to write? Thus, P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Again, therefore, by the principle of mathematical induction, it is true for all natural numbers, that is n. Now let us focus on the other problem. What is the problem given next? It is prove by the following, by using the principle of mathematical induction, for all n belongs to n, prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction, for all n belongs to n, n into n plus 1 into n plus 5 is a multiple of 3, is a multiple of 3. We are supposed to prove that the given terms, they are the multiple of 3. Then again, let the given statement be P of n. The same steps repeated. Let the given statement be P of n, that is P of n such that n into n plus 1 into n plus 5 is a multiple of 3. We shall consider that P of n is true for n is equals to 1. That is how you are going to write. It can be proved that let P of n is true for n is equals to 1. How we are going to write it? वन इंटू वन प्लस वन इंटू वन प्लस फाइव, दिस इज इक्वल्स टू वन इंटू टू प्लस सिक्स, नथिंग बट ट्वेल्व, सिंस ट्वेल्व इज द मल्टीपल ऑफ थ्री. ट्वेल्व इज द मल्टीपल ऑफ, ट्वेल्व इज द मल्टीपल ऑफ थ्री, देयरफॉर इट इज ट्रू फॉर n is equals to 1. Let P of K be true. For again, the next step is what? The next step is that let P of K be true for some positive integer K. For some positive integer K. That is how we are going to write then. We are going to write it as K into K plus 1 into K plus 5 P of K, such that K into K plus 1 into K plus 5 is equals to, we shall write it as 3M, 3M where M belongs to N set of natural numbers. Let us consider this as equation 1. Now what we are going to do, we shall prove for that P of K plus 1 is true. Now we shall prove that P of K plus 1 is true. We need to prove it for P of K plus 1. How we are going to simplify that? We are going to write it as K plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 1. That is K into, that is for the next K plus 1 terms, written as K plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 5. We got this as K plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 5. This can be written as K plus 1 into K plus 1 plus 1 can be written as K plus 2. Next, we are going to write it as K plus 1 into K plus 2. This can be written as K plus 5 plus 1. How we have written this? K plus 1 plus 5, that is written as K plus 5 plus 1. Then taking out what? K into K plus 1 into K plus 5. This is written as K into K plus 1 into K plus 5 plus 1. This can be first written as taking out K plus 1 into K plus 2 into K plus 5 into K plus 2 into K plus 5 plus, again we should write that here we have plus 1, no, just multiply, that is K plus 1 into K plus 2. What we got? We got K plus 1 into K plus 2 into K plus 5 plus K plus, multiplying that with 1, we got K plus 1 into K plus 2. This can be further written as K into K plus 1 into K plus 5 plus 2 into K plus 1 into K plus 5. Again we have plus K plus 1 into K plus 2. We are, what we have done, just splitted the terms, K into K plus 1 into K plus 5 plus 2 into K plus 1 into K plus 5 plus K plus 1 into K plus 2. This, see, K into K plus 1 into K plus 5, this can be replaced by, that is k into k plus 1 into k plus 5, this can be replaced by 3m is equals to 3m plus 2 into k plus 1 into k plus 5 plus k plus 1 into k plus 2. Now what we have done? We have written it as 3m plus 2 into k plus 1 into k plus 5 plus k plus 1 into k plus 2. This can be written as 3m plus, taking out k plus 1 common. Now what we'll do? 3m plus, taking out k plus 1 common, we are left with 2 into k plus 5, and here we have it as k plus 2. What we have done? Taking out k plus 1 common. This can be further written as what? This can be written as 3m plus k plus 1 into, just simplify, 2k plus 10 plus k plus 2. After taking out here common, we have, that is k plus 2. This can be written as 3m plus k plus 1 into 3k plus 12. We are supposed to prove that it is a multiple of 3. K plus 1 into 3, we got it as k plus 1 into 3k plus 12. This can be written as 3m plus, taking out again 3 common here, 3 times of k plus 1 into, I am again left with, taking out 3 common, k plus 6. This k plus 6 can be written as k plus 1 plus, it is 3 fours are 12. This can be written as 3m, that is 3 is common, m plus k plus 1 into k plus 4. We got it as 3 into m plus k plus 1 into k plus 4. We had m into m plus 1 into m plus 5. Then how we can say that? We can say that it is true for p of k plus 1. This can be written as 3q, where q is equals to m plus k plus 1 into k plus 4. Therefore, or thus, p of k plus 1, thus p of k plus 1 is true whenever p of k is true. So again, by the principle of mathematical induction, we say that it is true for all natural numbers n. Let us focus on one more problem, that is what they have given. Prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. Prove the following by using the principle of mathematical induction. For all n belongs to n, 10 raised to 2n minus 1 plus 1 is divisible by 11. We need to prove that 10 raised to 2n minus 1 minus 1 plus 1 is divisible by 11. Let us start proving it. What they have given? Let p of n be the given statement. Let p of n be the given statement. Then what is going to happen here? P of n such that 10 raised to 2n minus 1 plus 1. What we'll consider? We'll consider that P of n is true for n is equals to 1. P of n is true when n is equals to 1. Why? Since just P of 1 such that 10 raised to 2 into 1 minus 1 plus 1, that is 10 plus 1 is equals to 11, divisible by 11 is divisible by 11, is divisible by 11. Next, let us assume that, or let P of k be true for some positive integer k. Let P of k be true for some positive integer, for some positive integer k. Then how we are going to write it? It is written as 10 raised to 2k minus 1 plus 1. How we can write it? 10 raised to 2k minus 1 plus 1 is divisible by 11. Is divisible by 11. Now we shall prove that P of k plus 1 is true. Now we shall prove that P of k plus 1 is true. What we are going to do now? We'll prove that P of k plus 1 is true. To prove P of k plus 1 is true, what we'll do? First we'll consider this is equals to m, where m belongs to the set of natural numbers. What we'll do? This is equals to m, where m belongs to n. Let this be our equation 1. Now we shall prove that P of k plus 1 is true. To prove P of k plus 1 is true, what we'll do? 10 raised to 2k plus, means write down, 10 raised to 2k plus 1 minus 1 plus 1. This can be written as 10 raised to 2k plus 2 minus 1 plus 1. Nothing but 10 raised to 2k plus 1 plus 1. What we got? We got 10 raised to 2k plus 1 plus 1. This can be written as 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 2 into 10 raised to 2k. We are just simplifying it like 10 raised to 2k minus 1 plus 1 again into this is going to be minus 10 square plus 1. Just we have done 10 square into 10 raised to 2k plus 1 minus 10 square plus 1. This, what is 10 raised to 2k plus 1? 10 raised to 2k minus 1 plus 1 is equals to m, right? That is why in place of this, we can write as m, that is 10 square m minus 10 square plus 1, that is 10 square m is divisible by 11, right? So here it's going to be is divisible by 11, means it is going to be equal to 11 m minus 10 square plus 1. Nothing but you can here write what is 10 square. It is 100 into 11 m minus 99. 10 square is 100, 100 minus 100 plus 1 is going to be minus 99. So we got 100 into 11 m minus 99. This can be further written as 11 into just taking out 11 outside, 100 m minus 9. 11 into 100 m minus 11 9s are 99. We got the same previous step. So we got it as 11 into 100 m minus 9. So this can be written as 11 into q, where q is equals to 100 m minus 9. What we can write? Q is equals to 100 m minus 9. That is why what is going to happen? It is divisible by 11. Therefore, we can say that P of k plus 1 is true. What we got to know? Therefore, 10 raised to 2 k plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 is divisible by 11. Thus, P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. Hence, again by the principle of mathematical induction, it is true for all natural number, that is n. So, students, we are repeatedly doing the same types of problems, and I hope you all are following the problems. Keep studying, keep solving these kinds of problems, and stay safe. Thank you.